I'm going to make sure that now 11 weeks since we lost 19 kids and their two teachers shot to death with a weapon originally designed for use in combat, legally purchased by an 18-year-old who did not try to obtain one when he was 16 or 17, but followed the law that's on the books, ladies and gentlemen, that says that you can buy not one, you can buy two or more if you want to, AR-15s, hundreds of rounds of ammunition, and take that weapon that was originally designed for use on the battlefields in Vietnam to penetrate an enemy soldier's helmet at 500 feet and knock him down dead, up against kids at 5 feet. It may be funny to you, motherfucker, but it's not funny to me, okay?
So Beto got a pretty good response to that line right there. I mean, many of the people in the room were supporters of his candidacy, but there were a few protesters, I guess. And he got some heckling. And look, the heckling can be annoying in the best of times, but when you're talking about children being murdered in the state you're in very recently, the idea that you as a protester would take that opportunity to attack a candidate who's raising this issue and trying to make sure that the country doesn't forget about it, doesn't just move on, that's a weird time to attack him. And so while I would criticize Beto on quite a bit, I think that on policy he's been very hit or miss. His candidacies sometimes have gone to some weird places. And I can't say that that's not to some extent an artificial thing. Like, he wants to have that moment with the protester. I get why people would be fired up by that, Adrian. But what did you think about it?
You know, seeing some people and their responses to lives being taken and their love of supporting guns and defending it, it's so incredibly disheartening, because these are baseless actions. These are disgusting human beings who are out here who thinks it's acceptable to mock the idea that children were slaughtered and murdered and that law enforcement didn't protect them, that these weapons that were used to take their lives are completely and totally ridiculous in the hands of civilians, and to mock it, like, get out of here. It's depraved.
Yeah, I think depraved is the perfect word for it. Now the issue is that despite being so obviously better on this issue, the polling's still pretty rough. So we're gonna show you some of the recent polls going back, a couple of months there, actually longer than a couple of months there. And Abbott, look, Abbott's not like totally blowing him away, but in the most recent polls, he's still 5, 6, 7, 8 points up. But this is an issue that I think Beto is right to focus on. Back in December, when asked voters there, when they were asked who would do a better job on gun policy, Abbott got 60%, O'Rourke got 33%. Just in the last week, it's now 47 Abbott, 43 O'Rourke. So a very tight narrowing there. But elections aren't done just about one issue. So it makes sense for Beto to focus on this. But Abbott is a guy who can be criticized on so many different things: energy policy, immigration, abortion, all these issues. And so I think Beto needs to keep hitting him and hitting him harder.